Here we go. Foolproof. Hi there. I wanted to show you a couple of things about the smallies. You want to look for areas like this. You have the very strong current, and then you have the cliffs right next to them. If you're patient enough and if you spend a little bit of time, you're going to see that in the area right behind, in that calm water, most of the cases are you're going to see a few of them busting on the surface, and the minnows will be running like crazy. So you want to cast right here, so that, okay. So when they flip like this, definitely know that they're around, and you're hoping for a bigger boil where they'll really bust the minnows up and you get like hundreds of them jumping. There's another one. So all the minnows obviously cannot spend too much time in that strong current. They'll get tired eventually and they'll get closer to the cliffs, and this is where the smallies are waiting. They're really patient, I'm guessing, but they're really aggressive when they hit, so you'll know. There he is. Super strong fish right in the current. Six weight. There we go. Gorgeous fish. Of course, it's time to release this guy. One more time. I guess I'm not the only one fishing. And then I'm hooked up again. Not a beautiful fish. The smallies like this area right next to the current, behind the rocks, just perfect. When you look back in the slack water, this is where they boil the little minnows, and this is where you can expect to get some good action with them. Let's see this guy. Thank you. How about that? A little weighted hair jig. Just a quick release here. Beautiful smallmouth bass in the Wisconsin River. Doesn't get much better than this. Crappies with big little flies too. Trout. Welcome back to the LyubakaVideo. I'm gonna switch back to a fly that I know produces. This is a hourglass clouser. My good buddy Trevor made it for me, and I'm really grateful. Now that he's at work and I'm fishing, it's really proven to be helpful for me, not so much for him. But pretty soon, when he gets the whole summer off, I'll be working like crazy. And I'll be kicking myself in the butt for not having a job like his. Anywho, this really is about the same size as the river shiners that are around the Wisconsin River. It has a pretty natural movement through the water, and I've been really glad with the results. I've caught crappies, I've caught walleyes with it. The smallies definitely like it. And sometimes you get some of the other fish like carp, and I'm still to catch a pike on this one, but I've caught plenty of pike on white woolly buggers. The only problem is I still haven't figured out a good way to get them to bite, but not bite me off. So enjoy the rest of the show, hopefully I'll get a few more, and I want to show you some of the dandies that I'm catching. Thank you. I just dipped a scoop, and this is what's in the water. Little river shiners. So that is the size. The smallies are really liking those. And this is the size of the fly, just to compare. Fly, you know. I didn't speak too soon. I switched to the 9 weight, and I switched to that beautiful clouser minnow. And guess what? Now I have a white bass on. Something else, I want to do a two-way presentation with the flies. I'm gonna have a little crayfish imitation. I'll show you a picture of it after that. And I'm gonna fly tie that a little bit lower than the original jig that I have. So instead of making two separate knots on the line, I'll actually tie it straight to the bend of the hook. This way, when I feel I don't need it anymore, I'll just flip it off. Eventually what you get is this thing and this thing. So I'm gonna cut off the tag ends and then I'll fish with it. Thank you. So there it is, beautiful Wisconsin River smallmouth bass on the crayfish imitation. Time to let him go. What can you do? That's fishing. I decided to try something a little different this time. Since there's so many minnows and you can scoop them readily. Well, the smallies are busting them up. So I'm using a pitching technique that's usually used in salt water. Especially for snook and redfish when you're casting next to ducks and cover. I'm using my braided line, but then it's tied to a 10-pound fluorocarbon leader and just a plain hook. And what you do is you cast and you watch your line and you get them, because when they hit like that, you know that they're feeding on the minnows. Why not give them something they've already taken? And there it is. Beautiful Wisconsin River smallie. You hear somebody else is lying in his mouth. So he's definitely been feeding well. I'm gonna clip this closer and I'm gonna release him. Hooked up again, pitching those little minnows, and I'm gonna see this guy. What a nice fish. Jumper. Nice and heavy fish. Yeah, it's working. A little shiners on a little single hook. You just pitch it along those cliffs where you see them jumping. You can twitch it, of course, or just reel it. But let it sit. Everything will work. Nice, beautiful fish. Take a couple of pictures and let him go. Beautiful smallies, Wisconsin River. The best part of it all, the release of the fish. Look at these colors. Awesome. There's another one. You can tell this one's been beat up quite a bit. They do fight among them, but having the symmetrical marks on both sides kind of tells us that this is not another smallie. Most likely it's a bigger fish. And there's plenty of them in the Wisconsin River, especially muskies and big northerns. Let's hook this one off and let it go.
Máximo um vídeo.